One of the things that I have missed most about not living in a house anymore and living in an RV, besides my daughter, she's grown and left the nest. Besides her, it's having hummingbird feeders. I think I went probably a whole year and a half without a hummingbird feeder. Maybe it was only a year. I'm not sure. I can't remember. And I just missed those beautiful little creatures so much. So I just decided I was going to find something that would work well for the camper. And at first I thought maybe like a hook, you know, just a little small one that I could stick in the ground and maybe hang a little feeder on. But just stuff that I was looking at wasn't quite what I was wanting. So I found a couple. The first one is this. Isn't this so stinking cute? It's a little mason jar with little rubber flowers. It works really well. It doesn't hold a lot of juice, which is fine because we travel every 1 to 2 weeks. So I don't want to waste a bunch of nectar. If you hear weird noises in the background, my old dog Moose is chewing on a bone up in the living room. So I apologize.
I picked this one up last summer at Walmart for $6 or $7, but you can find them at Home Depot, Lowe's, and I did also find a clear one with red flowers on Amazon. The fill line is very handy, and the cute little hummingbird is just so stinking cute. This feeder is very easy to clean. The silicone flowers pop out, so you can really get in there with a straw cleaner. My only complaint is sometimes the wire hanger moves off where it's supposed to hang from, which makes it off balance, and then the nectar spills all over. But if you just check them before you hang it, it's no biggie. You can hang this feeder on a small shepherd's hook, maybe a plant hook attached with alien tape to the side of your RV, or from a suction hook on the front cap of your fifth wheel, which is what I did, and it worked great. As always, you can find links for everything in the description below.
And then I found this one on Amazon. I love it. It's very easy to use. It has the little thing so they can sit and they'll stay longer. If it has a little spot where they can sit, they'll stay longer and drink. Otherwise, if they just have that, they're hovering and I think they get tired. I don't know, maybe not. But I like to have them stick around. So this having the little place for them to perch was perfect. Again, it doesn't hold a lot of juice, but that's good, you know. And then it came with a suction cup and it went through here, and the suction cup was pretty good, but I decided I didn't want to risk it falling because, you know, suction cups are iffy. So I just hang it on a command hook right outside my kitchen window. Sometimes I hang it on a different window. It just kind of depends where the sun is at, but pretty much at the kitchen. That way I can watch them while I'm doing dishes.
This window-mounted hummingbird feeder is absolutely perfect for your RV. The plastic is pretty thick. It's very easy to take apart and clean, and the flowers also come off easily. Sometimes this clip is a little bit tricky, but once you figure out the best way to grip it so you can squeeze those little prongs together, it's easy. But it always pops right back in pretty easy.
They're both very small and lightweight, which is perfect for RV travel. I keep them in a small container under my sink, and they ride very well. Never had any issues. So I have a few tips for you also to keep it from getting moldy and gross. So a few things you can do to prevent mold is, first, just make sure you find one that's easy to wash. You want to definitely wash it with every change of nectar or every refill. You really need to change the nectar out like once a week. The next thing you're going to want to do is place it in the shade as much as possible. I know it's hard in an RV, but just make sure you place it in the shade, because then you have less condensation building up inside from the sun, and the mold won't grow as fast. And when you clean it, you want to clean it really well. I usually use an antibacterial dish soap and then just rinse it out really well with hot water. Or even a vinegar rinse if it got really moldy, because sometimes if you have it in the sun, it doesn't even take that long. It'll get full of mold and you don't want that. Another thing that will attract them, of course, is flowers. And the two that I have found that attract them the most, first of all, petunias. They love petunias. And petunias are so cheap and easy to grow. So, I mean, you could put them in a little pot and just carry them around with you wherever you go. Another one is bleeding hearts. Obviously, there's tons of different flowers that hummingbirds love, but I have found those two to be, they just go nuts for them. I have been making my own hummingbird nectar for ever since I can remember, ever since I pretty much started feeding them. My mother-in-law told me how you can make it, and I was like, well, heck, I'm going to make it because that stuff's expensive. So I thought I'd share that recipe with you. It's really easy, and it's very easy to store in the RV. So it's really just 2 cups of sugar to 4 cups of water. You don't have to boil it, but I do like to just bring it to kind of like a little simmer just because it helps the sugar to dissolve quicker. But as long as you could just use warm tap water and stir it really well until all the sugar's dissolved. You have to use white sugar. Don't use brown sugar or honey or anything like that. It has to be white sugar, and you can definitely use tap water. One thing you definitely do not want to do is add any red dye. It's not necessary because I don't know how they find it. Maybe it's the red, I don't know, but this one doesn't have red and they find it. I mean, they have, I've had them go to white petunias, and I mean, that's just white and green. So I don't think color really matters. Somehow they just find it. They probably can smell it. I don't know. But they find it. So you don't need any red dye. It's just not necessary, and it could harm them.
If you have any leftover nectar after filling your feeder, you can store it in an airtight container. A mason jar would work really well. I really like this container with the pour lid because it makes refilling my feeders so much more convenient. And just be sure to store your nectar in the refrigerator. If you see mold growth in the container before you get the chance to use it all up, it's best just to make a new batch. So let's get this thing loaded up and hang it outside. Here's a quick tip. Carry it outside before you turn it over. That way, if it spills, it'll spill outside and not in your RV. Also, if you turn it over real fast, it won't drip.
Okay. Dumb mosquito. Ooh. I think I got it. Don't worry. If you've been struggling with ants in your RV, click this video right here. It worked for us, and I promise it'll work for you. And this video is the best banana pudding recipe ever. You're gonna love it. It's the perfect dessert for any occasion and any time of year. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.